So guys, we are eating outside today. So this is what we are eating. We're eating our stir fried beef. So that's Stephanie's food. Let's see if she will finish it. That's mine. That's Christopher's. And that's our fruit. Drinks. Can't do without my cook. Sorry you. So guys, while we are eating, I will be telling you about Nigerians' attitude in UK that I have experienced, which is really so disgusting. So eat with us.
Yeah, let's go. Call him excellent God.
Hello everyone and welcome to the G family.
So in today's video we are just going to be having fun outside. The weather is beautiful and we are having our food outside. While we are eating, we will be gisting, I mean like talking, okay? So come and eat with us, right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Please pray for us.
Christopher. Heavenly Father, and of the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. God, I pray that you should bless and sanctify this food in Jesus' name. Amen. I pray that you should cut this food in the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, and Jesus' name. Amen. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Stephanie is using left hand to do the name of the Son. So guys, why the breeze is blowing everything away? This food looks so yummy, so I'm just going to take time to enjoy it and eat it quickly so that I don't get cold. So this is my stir-fried beef, guys. Before cooked with fruit. It's so nice. Look at this one shouting, yeah.
Don't take it more tea, but
it's so amazing. It tastes so nice. She's saying that she loves the food. It's really so
mint.
More tea, do not so mint.
So guys, I want to talk to you about my experience with Nigerians here. Nigerians are so ungrateful. Here in the UK, I don't know anywhere else, some Nigerians are so ungrateful. The way they speak to people, it just makes you feel like, well, the country where you are coming from, you don't have all these facilities, but when you are here, you behave like you are from a place that is better than here. So this food is nice. Very nice. So one day, then I was standing on the bus stop waiting for a bus. And I saw this Nigerian person, a guy, who was eating something. And he's finished eating what he was eating. And there's a bin just close to him here where he can put the rubbish. He just threw it on the floor. And I just shook my head and somebody said to him, excuse me, there's a bin there. You can just pick it up and put it there. And then he said, no, I can't do that. I have to throw it on the floor. Somebody will clean it. Oh my goodness. I'm thinking like, really? Where you are coming from, the way he's talking, you just knew that he's a Nigerian. And I'm thinking like, where you're coming from is so dirty and they are just paying people trying to keep this country clean and you're throwing things on the floor and saying somebody will come and pick it up. That is number one thing. They are so ungrateful. If you have experienced something like this, leave your comment in the comment section. I'm so enjoying this food. So juicy and fruity. Can I hear Christabel doing, if it were to be garlic, it should be money. So, another one is, I think it was this time last year or sometime August, 2 years ago, Christabel had an accident, so we went to hospital. She already had the surgery, so we have doing this. I think it was weekly check. We went to check. So it was on a school day. So this lady came in with her son, and then they went to. I just remember now. So she went to the reception, and the receptionist said, "I need to see your letter. You know, when you have an appointment, they will send you a letter to confirm. So when you get to the hospital to check in at the reception, you show them the letter." She said she doesn't have the letter. And they said, "Oh, we sent you a letter." She said, "Yes." He said, "We want to see the letter. The doctor has said that we should confirm your address." And this lady started insulting the receptionist. "Oh, you guys are incompetent. Oh, Loshi. Oh, this and that." She started insulting, abusing this girl in Yoruba. And I'm sitting down there. I'm feeling like the girl, the receptionist just kept quiet. She didn't talk. And this girl is insulting her. And this girl didn't realize that she also is a Yoruba. Why she finished abusing her? She said to her, "If you're finished insulting me, you're thinking that I didn't hear you. That's fine. This is not Nigeria. In Nigeria, before you walk into the hospital to say, 'Check my son,' you will pay for card. We are not asking you to pay for card. What we are asking you here is bring your confirmation later, because you said you have changed your address. So we know we are sending you letters, or your details are still the same or have been changed. So if you don't bring it, we are not going to see your son." And then she said, "Oh, I left what I was doing at home, and this child has missed his morning lesson just because of this appointment." And the lady turned to say, "I was not the one that broke the child's hand. I was not the one. Was I the one? You're the one that want doctor to see your child. So bring the confirmation letter. If you don't bring it, your appointment is safe. But when the letter is not here, we are not seeing your son." When she realized that it is no longer what she thought, and then she said, "I'm sorry, the letter went through, and the lady said it's too late. You should have been nice from beginning. So I have gotten an instruction from the doctor. If you don't bring the letter, we are not seeing your son." She left. That is number two. Nigerians are so ungrateful. In Nigeria, many people die at the reception hall without even seeing the nurse or a doctor, just because they haven't paid for card. But here, if you're sick, your health is priority to the doctors and nurses. They will look after you, and they are treating you nicely, but all we know is how to abuse them, how to use our local language to insult them. It is not nice. It is uncalled for. We have to be grateful. What you have here, you don't have it back home. I tell you, you have to have a change of attitude. Be grateful. I'm enjoying this food. If I talk a little bit, I eat a little bit, okay? I don't enjoy this food. You don't eat it, you pack it to one side alone. Bulldozer is almost done. So guys, number three. If you are in the UK, have you ever visited Nigerian embassy, the consulate? Have you ever visited it here? If you go to Swedish embassy, any other embassies I've visited, they have seats inside. I've been to Swedish embassy, the Nigerian embassy in Sweden, the consulate in Sweden. They have, at least they have seats. The place is not too big, but when you go there, they have seats inside where you can actually go in. After queuing outside, if you are calling, you have a place to sit down. In UK here, there's no, it's only the security that is outside insulting everybody, and they will be a long queue. And when you get there, even the good morning or good afternoon you will greet, the man will want to
you spit on your face. What are you doing here? Why are you here? Do you have an appointment? Hey, well, when are we going to change? They insult us in Nigeria. Even here, you have to learn manners of approach. A little bit. Here, whether they know you or not, you have an appointment. Do you have an appointment? Yes. Okay. Can I see your appointment later? What time is your appointment? Or what is your name? Give me your last name. You tell them. Very, very polite. They will talk to you nicely. Nigerians don't know how to say, yes, please, thank you. They don't know how to say thank you. They don't know how to say please. Here, you go to the embassy. The way they will be shouting at you, even if you're carrying a child. And so, you're carrying a child. I mean, pay, help you burn the child. I steal our money to bring it here and bad mouth us on top of it. So, Nigerians, be polite and grateful. Learn something from Oyibo. Don't always learn the bad thing. Learn something from Oyibo. That's what I want to tell you. You have to learn good things. Be polite. Be nice to your citizens, especially those that are working in the embassy here. It is so painful, so disgraceful. Let me eat a little bit of it. I'm coming. Nigerians, we like to fake. We too fake. We fake for Niger. We fake for here. You're gonna see somebody. When you get anything, go go Primark, go buy something. Go go buy a Gucci brooch. Is it brooch that they call it or whatever? And use it to pin on the cloth. And then the person will they will remove the label. They will start feeling like I'm wearing Gucci. I bet nobody they look at you. You see, in this country, if you like naked, if you like wear rag, if you like wear bag, take sack, sew your cloth, nobody send you. They know they look you. Now we do pass for our country, and now we do pass for here. Now we sabi take credit. Now we sabi buy things on credit. One day, when the name of this shop again? We don't close for Fusion. BHM. BHS. That's a British Home Stores. When that shop was in Fusion, I went to buy kids things there. I saw this lady. She came to return dress. My sister. This dress, she was telling the lady that, oh, she doesn't like the dress. That the dress is tight, this and this and that. And the dress, the lady is telling her that, oh no, this dress is smelling perfume. Their makeups on the dress is smelling perfume. That means it's been worn. He said, oh, it's only when she was trying. The woman said, no, you can't be trying dress and put perfume on the dress. So literally what they do is they will come and buy an expensive dress. When I was talking to one of my friends, he said, hey, you don't know what is happening. Nigerians, what they do in this country is to go and buy expensive dress in the shop. They will wear it to party, feeling that somebody will be telling, feeling that, oh, they are expensive, oh, they have good clothes. They will not remove the tag on the dress. When they finish, come back from the party, they will go and return the dress to the store. No. Change now. Eh? It is too bad. You people have to be truthful to yourself. Me, I don't have to buy expensive clothes to look nice. You can buy cheap one and look nice. You don't have to fool yourself. Some of them will go to shop. They will go to Boots. They say they want to try makeup. They will allow the person that is trying the makeup. They will say, put this one. That one will put. They will say, put that one. That one will put. When they finish making them up, instead of them to buy the makeup, they won't buy. They will walk away. And meanwhile, they have already planned they are going for a party, so they are going to get free makeup. It's not fair. Let me just tell you people, you will think you are wasting somebody's time, or you are dealing with somebody, you are dealing with yourself. because you are fake. You're faking around everywhere. So nobody knows your real self. So, my dear people, these are the few things that I have experienced in the UK here as a Nigerian. And that is why when you say, tell somebody that I'm a Nigerian, they look at you like this. In the UK, change. We are better than this. You can be you. You don't have to be copy. You don't have to buy clothes and return it to shop after using it for a party. It is a sin against God. And now we go church pass. Now we preach pass. I bet make we change. Stephanie is finished eating her food. They want to start eating fruit. Mm-hmm. I know. She can't wait. Okay, use your hand to eat now. Okay, take two pieces.
Two pieces?
Mm-hmm.
Two pieces are for eating.
Yeah,
and
for eating.
Mm-hmm.
So guys, they are finished eating their food and the one left. So thank you for eating with us, and we enjoy making videos for you to watch. I'm sure the kids enjoy the food.
Mm-hmm.
For the first time, Stephanie finished her food. Mm-hmm. And she loves strawberry. So thank you guys for watching, for eating with us from the Chief family. This thing has grown on top of my food.
Bye.
Bye. We love you.
Love you. And don't forget to buy.